Okay, so I want to make a list on the board of what I'm looking for.
I can tell.
Happy talking.
Okay. The three things we're doing today, okay? We're gonna do this page. Page 243, we're doing number 1 through 28 events. I'm gonna do them, and you're gonna ask questions, and that's it. At the end of class, you'll turn in the handout from yesterday. You'll also turn this in. And then, I want to remind you that on June Sunday is Big Ideas Math. It's chapter 3.5. We talked yesterday that you can skip number 2.
Yay.
In chapter 3.6. Okay, so I'm going to do this even with now. I am collecting the handout with the units and you have online work as well.
Online work? Oh, I like to do that.
You don't have what?
Did I write that?
This is that online work in school. Is that online work in school? Basically. Describe the slope, then find the slope. By describe, they mean Is it positive? Is it negative? Is it undefined? Or is there no slope at all? Kaden, number two. Positive or negative?
It's negative. You speak to me. Bro, you made it seem. Bro, see, bro. No, I'm just saying. Do you know
how to do it? I know that so many of you are actually quite capable of doing this without my help. What I would like to do is give you time in class just to work, right? Some of you really want some help. You want to hear a teacher go through it. So you're either working independently or you're just listening to me. What is the positive slope here? With number two says a picture has been provided, you can actually count rise over run. So from the first point, I'm going to count up 1, 2, 3, 4. And we call slope M. So I'm going to say that I went up 4. And then from there, I'm going to go over 1, 2, 3. Then that's your slope.
One.
We're just doing even, so now I'm going to head over to number 4. This one's running downhill. So we'll call that one a negative slope. The ball is all right downhill. So a negative slope should have a negative number. So I'm going to start the point to the most left. And when I count down, I'm going to make that a negative number. I like to call this one fall over run. Instead of rise over run, you're actually falling over run. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I fall 4 units. Then I'm running 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I ran 5. So negative 4 over 5. And that's the same as if someone put a positive 4 over a negative 5. It's also the same as when the textbook types the negative sign perfectly in line with the middle. The middle, that sign can either go to the top or the bottom. It does not go to both.
Number 6.
So I like 2 and 4 the best because there's the picture to count rise over run. The rest of them are going to be more difficult. My options for 6 is I could make my own graph or I could use slope formula. So I'm going to erase this just for now. Well, she didn't practice this yesterday, so the first point I will label X1, Y1, and that just means first order pair. The second point I will label X2, Y2, and that just means second order pair. And so the Y's always go on top because the Y will show how much it rise or fall. Rise over run. So Y's on top. And then the X is down below because X is show how far it will run back and forth. So we got negative 5, minus sign, negative 2, negative sign, negative 7, minus sign 2. I'm just going to wait a minute and let you do that math before me.
So you can see it.
Maybe you're making any mistakes there. Grab out that calculator, whatever you're comfortable with using, and do your subtraction. So I would make this negative 5 minus the negative is actually addition. Right here, this minus the negative becomes addition. So kind of cancel each other out. Negative 7 minus 2 is negative 9. When I think about negative 5 plus 2, I think about the number line. If I'm over at negative 5 and I add 2, I end up at negative 3 over negative 9. These two negatives make a positive. And I can reduce this. The top and bottom both divide by 3. So this slope simplifies to positive 1/3.
Yeah, you can put these numbers first, as long as you get the same answer.
Find the slope. I'm gonna look and see how the x's are changing and how the y's are changing. So this one is moving up 3. Up 3. Changing y makes a rise. There's no rise in this. I better get a visual. What does it mean if the y's aren't changing? I'm going to take a look and see what this table actually looks like. Negative 1, negative 6, 2, negative 6, 5, negative 6, 8, negative 6. This is a perfectly flat line. There is no rise. So this would be 0, over 3, up by 3. So 0 over 3 equals 0. This is called zero slope or no slope. When y doesn't change, you're looking at a flat, no slope line. Number 10. This is plus 1, plus 1, plus 1. X increases by 1. How is y changing? By 7. Did we also find that they're increasing by 7? Oh, negative 7. Yeah, those numbers are becoming more for negative.
What?
-7. Why is z decreasing by 7? So my slope is negative 7 over 1. So let me write
slope 1 on our way.
No. Now, did you write it negative 7 over 1 or just?
Yeah, I wrote it.
Okay. And then you guys know that's the same as just negative 7. So you're allowed to just write negative 7. What'd you write? Sure, I'll take it. Okay, there's actually like 3 different ways. There's even more than 3 ways you can think about your slope. For me, I always think about this first way, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. I hear a lot of you thinking about it as rise over run. And then the one I've been talking about with tables is you put how much the y's change over how much the x's change. Is there any other ways? You could also talk about rate of change. Rate of change is also slope. All right, let's move on to number 12. The table shows the number of the amount x in hours,
the time you spend at a theme park,
and the admission fee for the park. The points in the table line on line try and interpret the slope. So the hours are going up by 1. No slope again. 0 over 1, which is 0. So when it says interpret, that means you have to explain the situation with a sentence. So I'm going to say,
the fee does not change each hour. Which makes sense. This means you paid $4.99 to get in. You're there for 6, 7, 8 hours. It's still just the $4.99. You don't have to go back and pay to get in again. You stayed. Can you see that one okay?
All right.
Yes, per nature, good. Harry, what number are you on? 16 is the one we often forget because there's actually no rides over run. Well, I'm going to visualize it first. I'm going to go to where Y is negative 1 on the graph, and I'm going to draw a line. Okay, Y equals is a horizontal line through negative 1. So the slope in this situation is 0. One way to kind of look at this differently or to overcomplicate. 16. Look, James, I think you'll totally get this. Is if I put y equals 0x minus 1. Because there's no rise over run, the slope is 0. It's like there's a 0x there. And 0 times x is 0. So it's 0 minus 1. So that's why the equation is y equals negative 1. It's because there was a 0 in front of that x. The slope was 0. 0 slope line. The y-intercept is negative 1. The only thing that's present there is an actual b value. That's a b value. Yes? We're going to number 28. In standard form also. It's not in the right order. The most difficult thing we did yesterday on the handout was to rearrange the equations. We had to go from standard form to getting y alone. So here's y.
I want you to rearrange that so it's in slope-intercept form. Put a line here. It moves something to get y alone. Perfect, yeah. Subtract the x. It's a positive x. So we're going to minus it here. And on the other side of the line. And I'd like to put dx directly in between the equal sign and the number. So it looks like y equals mx plus b. So it's y equals negative x minus 6 and 1 half.
I'm going to say the m value is negative 1, the b value is negative 6 and 1 half.
So that negative 1 is like your slope is down 1, right 1, down 1, right 1.
I want to go ahead and say, with a problem like this,
when you have to rearrange,
there's more than one right way to do it. You don't necessarily have to do it one way or another. I'd like for you to try something before you just copy me. There's two perfectly valid ways I would consider doing this one. Okay. Now, we have believing y right where it is. Now, if my goal is to end with y next, let's say, on the left side, and mx plus b on the right side, what might be the easiest thing to do first?
So if you decided to move to 2y, that's okay.
Y is almost alone. It's on the right side. That's okay. Y doesn't always necessarily have to be on the left side.
So this is negative 2 times y. And then divide both sides by negative 2. What did you say? I really want to get a calculator and divide 4.8 by 2. Yesterday I told you that this is the same as splitting a fraction. So we could do negative 4.8 over negative 2x minus 4.5 over negative 2 equals y. Positive 2.4, negative over a negative. And then 2.25. David, you're doing this. You got it.
Yeah, you're right.
So the slope of this case is the 2.4 because it's the coefficient of x. And the y-intercept is the 2.25.
Does anybody want to do that one like differently at all?
Yes.
Should we do it again? No, I'll take it.
Yeah. Somebody who wrote it down. You said you did too first time.
No, I did.
Oh, no, you said it.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was.
You didn't say anything. You said no.
You guys, there's still time. You have to go to 28.
Did you not turn this into
that
right? Did you turn this into that?
Yeah, that was my plan.
Alright,
so I was going to
back the deal.
Okay, so what option are you going to look at this? One option is to add the 2.1 to y over.
You act toward. Hold on. I look at you. You act toward.
No, I need to. So I'm like,
oh.
Oh.
Oh. Oh. Oh.
Look at the way you saw it. I move the 2y. Then I just have to divide by 2 and I'm done. So this way has less negatives and less steps.
Oh, I knew that. I don't know that.
Just a minute.